Okay, assalamualaikum and good morning everyone. Okay, so how is your assignment 5? I hope everyone has maybe no problem with it. Okay, because I've told you that just read for the book I given to you. Hopefully you guys can do it, okay? So for today, we are going to learn on new physics, meaning new lectures. So we are going to learn on the biofluid mechanics. Okay, so lecture 7 is on biofluid mechanics. So in this lecture, students will be able to understand the steps involved in solving computation model using FM software and also solve and analyze various application of fluid mechanics model. So last week we have learned about biosolid mechanics. So another mechanics that another branch of mechanics is known as fluid mechanics. So fluid mechanics basically deals with the motion of fluid and the forces acting on them. So fluid consists of liquid and gases. Okay, so for solid only has one thing, which is solid, but for fluid it has both liquid and gas. So numerically solving the equation of fluid mechanics is very difficult, even if you use software. So existing software for fluid mechanics like ANSYS, what else, COMSOL and others, they use numerical method to solve. So fluid mechanics equation is very hard to be solved by hand, okay? Compared to other types of model like solid or electromagnetic, it's easier to be solved by hand. But for fluid, it's very difficult to be solved by hand. So only so far, most of the model software use numerical method to solve fluid mechanics. So in biomedical engineering, fluid mechanics modeling include, for example, the flow of blood in the heart and circulation, flow of air in pulmonary tracts. So for pulmonary tracts ni, paru-paru kita, okay? Peristaltic motion. Peristaltic ni dekat kita punya saluran makanan, okay? Esophagus. And also simulating prosthetic device such as heart valve, ventricular assist pump, stent, and also implantable drug. So in fluid mechanics, we have the term called strain rate. So dalam solid mechanics, we also have strain, but in fluid mechanics, we often use strain rate, meaning that kadar perubahan strain, okay? So the strain rate is denoted by this VIJ. Okay, tak penting, tapi kena tahulah ada strain rate. So in fluid mechanics as well, we have the term viscosity. Viscosity or in Malay, kelikatan. So like oil, the viscosity is higher compared to water. Meaning that oil kalau kita tuang dekat atas meja, dia bergerak slow berbanding air. So in fluid, it has two more properties. One of it we call incompressible. So one of the assumption for fluid, we assume the fluid is incompressible. Maksudnya fluid tu dalam in order to solve the fluid mechanics model, we assume that the fluid cannot be compressed. Even though in real life the fluid is compressible, but to make the solution for the fluid mechanics easier, we assume fluid to be incompressible. And another one is isotropic. Isotropic, the same with solid mechanics, meaning that the properties is equal or homogenized in the fluid. So for fluid mechanics, the constitutive equation is in this form. So here we have stress term here, sigma ij. So to describe the fluid mechanics, we also use stress tensor. And the stress is related to the fluid pressure and also the strain rate here. So for Newtonian fluid, we use mu, which is the viscosity, to be constant. Sometimes we have mu in the form of in terms of temperature or pressure, and for Newtonian fluid, mu is constant. And we have two more terms for fluid mechanics. We have laminar flow. So laminar flow is when the fluid motion has strain rate that remain constant with time, or the flow is steady, or laminar. So basically, laminar flow, dia punya properties, if you look at this velocity profile here, dia ada parabolic velocity profile for laminar flow. But for turbulence, kita boleh classify to differentiate laminar and turbulent by using the Reynolds number. So turbulent flow, dia punya velocity profile is no longer parabolic. Okay, korang yang belajar fluid lagi power bab Reynolds number ni. Okay, saya tak belajar fluid. Okay, so this is the difference between laminar and turbulent. So for laminar, it has parabolic profile, and for turbulent, dia tak berapa nak parabolic. Okay, ni tadi. So the basic for fluid mechanics equation is this, what we call Navier-Stokes equation. So Navier-Stokes equation ni is one of the most difficult equation that that people cannot solve by hand, other than if you put a lot of assumption, for example like incompressible, isotropic semua tu. So ni cerita luar topik lah, okay. So one of the famous problems in mathematics is solving Navier-Stokes equation. So there is a Nobel Prize lah in mathematics. We call it Millennium Prize. So to solve, for those who are able to solve the problems related to Navier-Stokes equation, so this funding body will give you 1 million kalau boleh solve Navier-Stokes equation. Lepas tu ada satu movie ni, dia buat dia cerita tentang this guy yang manage to solve Navier-Stokes equation. Lupa dah nama movie tu apa. So menarik lah movie tu, saya pun tak pernah tengok, kawan je yang cerita. So Navier-Stokes equation ni kalau in finite element software, dia just guna numerical method je nak solve, which is not accurate lah. So for incompressible fluid, the volume is conserved. So one of the assumption is volume is conserved, that making solving the Navier-Stokes equation easy if you use this assumption. So one of the assumption is continuity equation here, del dot velocity equals zero. Okay, dah habis dah merepek. Okay, so let's do tutorial on fluid mechanics. Okay, so the example given in the slide is related is regarding the aortic blood flow. So this is a simplified model for fluid mechanics, because since I said fluid mechanics, you are required to use numerical method to solve. So to solve fluid mechanics problem, it's it could take a long time if you use 3D geometry, or if you use complex geometry. So in this example, the geometry used will be a simple 2D axis symmetry. Okay, lagipun bentuk dia pun silinder je. Okay, kalau ambil bentuk yang complicated to solve with your laptop could be requiring a lot of RAM. Okay, so in this example, so consider the following simplified model of descending thoracic and abdominal aorta. So aorta is the blood vessel that carries the blood from your left ventricle to the whole body. So aorta ni adalah satu blood vessel yang sangat besar, sangat panjang, starting from your heart until your abdomen, okay, ke bahagian paru-paru thoracic until your abdomen. So dia sangat panjang, okay, dan sangat besar. Rasanya dia one of the biggest, rasanya dia paling besar lah kot, blood vessel in our body. So in this example, solve the model in COMSO and plot total blood flow against time for an input half sine pulse pressure pulse. So the pressure is given in this form, equals 120 sine 2 pi t for time from 0 until 0.5, and pressure is 0 for other value of times. And then assume the viscosity of blood is mu equals 3.5 millipascal second, and density equals 1000. So the blood is initially at rest. So usually we assume the blood as Newtonian fluid because it simplifies the computation. But for more rigorous model, sometimes we use non-Newtonian. Okay, so in this example, we use Newtonian only. Okay, so this is the step. So, nampak. Okay, let's try. Okay, so from the model wizard, so here we use 2D axis symmetry. So why we use 2D axis symmetry? Because this is cylinder. So if you look at the cylinder, if you can just solve the cross section of the cylinder, then it simplifies the computation a lot, okay, compared to solving the whole cylinder. So we can use 2D axis symmetry. And then we choose lamina flow. So fluid flow, single phase, lamina flow. And then next, we choose time dependent. Okay, so we start with geometry. So change the default length unit here to millimeter. So here what we do is we want the geometry to all be in millimeter instead of meter. And then we start with drawing a rectangle. Okay, so we can represent the cross section of cylinder using rectangle. So the width is 10 millimeter, the height is 300 millimeter. Okay, so if you revolve this rectangle 360, then it becomes a cylinder. Okay, then we define the parameters. So the first parameter is the viscosity. And the maximum pressure. And the resistor from the Winkelsel model. So this is your Winkelsel model. This is the Winkelsel model. We have learned Winkelsel model back in lecture 3 MATLAB again, yang ada MATLAB tu. So here we use Winkelsel to represent the resistance and compliance of the iota. So we can use electrical components to represent the properties of fluid, okay, fluid and fluid flow. So the R1 here is the resistor. So R1 is 1 mm Hg, second per centimeter cube. And the capacitor or the compliance is 2.75. And the density 1000, okay, silap. Okay, then we can define the variable in definition. So firstly is the P input. So the input pressure here, the half sine pulse pressure. So to define if else here, we can use in this form, okay. So if the time is less than 0.5, then the P in will be equal to P max times sine 2 times pi times T per second. Or else, if time is not less than 0.5, then P in is 0. Okay, that's the meaning of this if else here. Okay, so there are three components in the if else. First is the condition, which is time less than 0.5. Then the second component is what happened if times is less than 0.5. And then the third one is what happened if time is not less than 0.5. Okay, so there are three components in if for COMSOL. Okay, after you enter the P in, then we need to define some coupling here. So right click definition, go to couplings and integration, and then change this geometric entity level from domain to boundary and choose boundary number 2, which is this the bottom of rectangle, and then go to advanced, uncheck compute integral in revolved geometry. Okay, so what we did here, basically we want to find the integration of this line when you revolve the line. So when you integrate this this line revolving at 360 degrees, meaning that you are finding the area of the cylinder, the bottom of the cylinder, which is the circle. Okay, so go to variable and then define the flow, fluid flow Q equals integration operation 1 of negative 2 times pi times R times W. So R here is the distance of this, okay, the distance, the length of the bottom of the circle here, and W represent the velocity of the fluid. So Q basically flow is equals velocity times area, okay. Okay, and then we go to laminar flow. Laminar flow, and then go to fluid properties. So you just substitute density with rho and viscosity with mu. Okay, so now we set the boundary condition. So first we set the inlet. So for fluid, we have inlet and outlet. So firstly is the inlet. So inlet, we assume the top of the rectangle. And then the inlet, as what the question give, is equals to PT, the pulse pressure. So we just put here P in. But change this to pressure first, okay? Boundary condition to pressure. Okay, sorry, so this is P in. And then we set for outlet. So outlet is the bottom of the rectangle. So we use pressure as well. And here we write P out. Okay, so uncheck the suppressed backflow. Uncheck suppressed backflow. Okay, so P out here will be in yellow because we haven't defined what is P out. So to define P out, we use the Winkelsel model. Okay, so to add Winkelsel model, we need to add global ODE and DAE from add physics. So you can go to physics, the top here, click add physics. And then here in add physics, you can find global ODE and DAE here. Global ODE and DAE. Double click. And then you can close the add physics. Okay, then we set this in the global ODE and DAE. So go to global equation here. So in the global equation, we have something here written FU, UT, UTT, T equals zero. So UT naught is U naught, UTT, T naught is UT naught. So basically, what is written here is, conteng sikit lah. Okay, so firstly is your Winkelsel model first. Okay, let's look at your Winkelsel model. So this is the Winkelsel model. So we can derive the Winkelsel model. Alah, macam nak derive, lupa lah. So here the equation is already given here. So from the Winkelsel, basically the formula is C times dP out dt plus P out over R equals Q. Okay, so the flow out from the aorta, the flow Q equals C dP out over dt plus P out R. Okay. So Q ni ibaratnya macam current, okay? So the current flow equals the sum of current going to capacitor plus the sum of current going to the resistor. Okay, so the current through capacitor equals C dP out dt and the current through resistor P out over R. So Q represent current and P out, the pressure represent the voltage, okay? The voltage of the electrical component. So in COMSOL, we have the term F U U T U T T T equals zero. So again, what we are going to do is we want to arrange this equation here so that it becomes equal zero. So we arrange them to be C P out dt plus P out of R minus Q equals zero. So now this term here becomes F because it basically equals already. So here we want to solve for P out. Okay, so we want to solve for P out, and we just write the equation C dP over dt plus P over R minus Q in here, representing F. So let's write, okay, from here, just copy and paste pun boleh. Okay, and then change unit. So you just write, you just copy and paste here. So dia akan jadi kuning sebab unit tak sama. So kita kena adjust unit. So here, adjust the unit. Change the unit of variable quantity to Pascal. And source term to meter cube per second. Okay, so the unit for variable quantity represent P out here. So P out, the unit is Pascal, and the source term represent the unit for F. So F just now, if you look at this, then F, the unit will be the same as Q. Okay, so Q, the unit is meter cube per second. Okay, unit of flow, meter cube per second. So you have set the Winkelser model in the in our model, and now you can go to study one. So the question asks to solve for okay that mentioned time. So we solve for time zero. From time 0 until 1, okay? So from time 0 until 1 with stepping 0.01. Okay, after you set this, you can try compute. So for fluid problem, it will take longer to solve. So kena sabar sikit.
Lama sir, lama.
Itulah. Itulah dia. Dia baru solve 0.003. 0.003. Belum even 0.01. Not even one time step. Okay. Okay, tak sabar je lah.
Hujung tu error sir.
Tak ada, tak ada error. Jangan. Okay, so usually for finite element software, to solve the model yang lambat dia, yang menyebabkan dia slow ialah masa awal-awal tu. So macam ni, masa awal-awal tadi slow sangat. Tapi bila dia dah solve a few initial time step, dia dah makin cepat dah. Kalau tengok dia punya solution dia dah sekejap dah 0.2 second. Awal-awal tadi macam lambat sangat nak sampai even 0.01 second. Normal in finite element method software. nak solve yang awal tu memang lambat, dan selalunya yang awal tu lah menyebabkan fail. So selalunya kalau fail dalam finite element software, kalau fail initial step tu mungkin salah setting lah. Obviously salah setting, salah geometry, salah boundary condition semua tu. Ini just some insights lah siapa yang buat finite element for FYP, okay. So if you manage to solve the first few seconds of your simulation, kalau salah yang the next maybe due to setting for the solver, okay. So setting for the solver dalam course ni saya tak ajar lah sebab dia sangat sangat bukan complicated, tapi it is more into experience juga. Siapa yang selalu buat, dia tahulah nak tukar apa, nak tukar kena guna solver yang mana, dengan juga kena read, banyak baca jugalah, okay, banyak tengok Google. So untuk course ni kita just tekan dekat study, setting time range and compute. Kita tak tengok macam mana nak tengok dia punya solver dia. Yang solver tu tak tahu macam nak ajar, memang susah sikit nak ajar yang tu. Okay, nak dekat separuh. So siapa yang buat project related to fluid, be reminded that it could take long time to solve. For fluid, project yang related to fluid, I would suggest you to do two dimension only, okay. Do not try three dimension, because three dimension lagi susah nak solve, lagi lambat. Tambah-tambah kalau guna laptop sendiri. So laptop sendiri, saya suggest guna 2D je. Even asymmetry pun tak payah kot. 2D yang biasa je. Buat bentuk square ke, rectangle, to represent your your model, your geometry. Okay, so project tu bolehlah start, okay. Sebab kita dah week 9. Next week, rasanya tak ada kelas. Adakah? 24 tu tak cuti lagi kan, boleh lah buat kelas satu. And then dah week 10 next week, so we have 3 more weeks for you to do the project. So my plan is week 13 we will do test 2. Week 13 lagi 4 minggu, and your presentation for project will be during study week, okay, week 14. Kalau buat semua week 13, nanti komplain dekat UMP confession pula. Okay, so regarding test, baik beritahu sekarang je lah, nanti lupa. So for test, there will be one question. Test 2. So one question. So topic will be chapter 7. So chapter 7, 6, 5, chapter 5, Maxwell equation. Okay, so please try to do tutorial and also assignment. So fahamkan macam mana nak setting boundary conditions, how to draw geometry, and also how to do parametric sweep. Okay, there will be one question. Tak muat lah. One question, 50 marks will be converted to 20%. Okay, one question tu ada anak dia lah, okay. Ada A, B, C, D, D ni ada D1, D2. Okey, ni je lah yang boleh diberitahu. Tak habis-habis lagi. Haa, cakap apa tak dengar?
Tak ada apa ke?
Carut ke tu? Macam nak fail je.
Chapter ni se ada assignment se.
Yang mana? Chapter ni? Ah, ada. Dah upload dah. Jam. Macam biasalah, mesti ada assignment.
Kena buat 3 hari awal je ni, ni ni.
Buat hari ni hujung minggu siap.
Dia saja yang nak bagi. Korang tak boleh hantar last minute. Lama betul laju. Hey, hari tu cepat je soft. Jam. Ah, cepatlah. Berapa minit dah ni dah ni. Aduh.
Kena extend submission dia ke kalau assignment ni tu?
Mana boleh. Simple je dia punya tutup assignment. Kita tengok soal assignment dulu lah. Okay. Zaim tak dekat. Okay, mana assignment tadi? Downloads. Okay, so sebelum kita sementara kita tunggu, kita tengok assignment dia dulu. So assignment dia benda sama juga. Sama je macam tutorial. Tetapi dia punya P in instead of you use if else and sine wave. So P in here is given in table form. So here I want you to explore how to input this in table. So the clue is given here. Right click definition, function, interpolation. So you use interpolation table. And then the same thing, plot for volume flow waveform, plot the axial component of velocity. Yang ni kena ada clue use cut line 2D in dataset. And then from C is the velocity profile parabolic. Ni kena tengok dari C lah. Okay, so here use cut line 2D in dataset. Please explore this. Dekat test nanti ada kena buat benda ni, kena explore, kena guna something like this in the dataset. Okay, kena buat something lah. Okay, so here please try explore how to use cut line 2D in dataset. Okay, so patutnya boleh siap lah dah sebab ambil je tutorial, tukar PIN je. Ha, dah boleh buat, boleh run dari sekarang. InsyaAllah siap hari Ahad minggu depan. Ya Allah, lambat eh. Wah, ada orang dah sampai rosak laptop.
Boleh rasa beli laptop baru.
Boleh rasa beli.
Kalau nak rasa laptop paju-paju tanya Zaim.
Semua Zaim kena kan?
Semua Zaim.
Tukar laptop, tukar laptop Zaim.
Kesian kawan tu.
Zaim perform
bahan. Asyik kena bahan je.
Zaim, hari Ahad pukul 11.50 pun boleh siapkan lagi assignment ni.
Dia laptop. Guna laptop power punya. Hei Zaim, Zaim. Oh, dia dah laju sikit. Okay, dah semakin laju. Alright, dah laju dah. Okay. Okay, dalam 2 minit lagi siap kot. Right? Slow balik. Jahanam. Okay, laju dah. Okay, sepanjang saya buat simulation ni, benda yang paling paling tension saya tengok, saya buat ialah melihat benda ni lambat gila nak habis. Tapi dia macam satisfying. Bila tengok, oh dia dah laju, yeay. Tapi sebenarnya dia pandang annoying tadi. Tambah-tambah bila dah separuh jalan, tiba-tiba fail. Tu paling rasa nak mencarut semua dia.
Part hujung fail pun terak ke? Mencabar agak.
Dah tiba 0 point kan, tiba fail. Tu lagi sakit, sakit hati.
Saya dah compute tinggal je.
Memang kalau saya tak boleh tinggal, saya selalu tengok macam benda ni macam saya tak sabar. Padahal tinggal je lah. So macam dulu saya punya PhD, satu simulation tu kadang-kadang satu hari dah siap. So kena buat dalam 20 simulation macam tu. So saya bosan, saya run sekali 20. Satu minggu, selepas seminggu baru tengok siap ke belum. So tak datanglah lab seminggu. So boleh, masa tu pergi jalan-jalan lah seminggu tu, pergi jalan. Kadang-kadang bila pergi jalan, rupanya simulation tu fail. Fail, hari kedua dah fail rupanya. So bazir seminggu. Kena run balik, run balik, pergi jalan balik. So PhD, saya banyak habis melihat benda ni run je lah. Setahun juga kot buat benda ni, tengok benda-benda run ni. Sadis, itulah memang sadis. Tapi nasib baik, PhD saya dulu 2 tahun yang pertama pakai MATLAB je. So pakai MATLAB dia okey je, tak ada masalah. Maksudnya cepat je. Yang tahun yang terakhir tu yang pakai software Final Element, yang tu yang stressful sikit. Sebab run, fail, run, fail. Kadang-kadang macam rasa nak rasa macam bangun pagi pergi lab untuk run simulation atau balik rumah. So macam tak tahu nak buat apa dah dekat Oxford masa tu. Pergi lab, run balik. Rasa macam bosan hidup macam tu. Tengok hasilnya, jadi idola banyak tu. Jangan habis bateri. Auto 1 week. So bateri 83%, banyak lagi. Oh dah siap dah. Okay, dah penat baby dia siap. Okay, kita tengok berapa lama dia soft tadi. Okay, 15 minit. Okay, so expect your simulation will be more than 15 minutes or around that time, okay? Okay, so lepas dah solve, kita boleh dah plot. So soalan ada suruh plot apa-apa. Okay, so 1D plot group. 1D plot group. Global. Y-axis data. So plot Q. So we want to see the flow. Plot. Okay, this is the flow. So flow dia macam sine tadi lah, sebab sine pressure input tadi dalam bentuk sine wave. So dia punya flow should be having the same form as sine wave lah. Okay. And then apa lagi dia plot? Okay, so we can plot this thing. So this is velocity. So here already plotted velocity. So here the velocity is plot in three dimension. So we can plot this using 2D plot. So let's try result 2D plot group. Right click 2D plot group surface. So spf.u ni velocity. So let's try. So this is your velocity. Tapi ni color kuning ni maybe dekat time yang lain. So we can change the time. Maybe halfway kot. 0.6. Maybe earlier. Okay, something like this. So this is the velocity. So simulation results of blood velocity magnitude in aorta at 1 second. Okay, 1 second. Maksudnya salah dah simulation kita. Tak sama resultnya. Okay, whatever lah. Okay. Showing zoom in view around the inlet boundary. So zoom in around the inlet. In each case, the axis of symmetry is the leftmost edge. Okay, so ni axis of symmetry. Maksudnya yang kita revolve tadi. Dekat edge belah kiri. Note that the velocity profile is not parabolic with maximum velocity at the axis since there is an oscillatory pressure gradient. Tak faham. Okay, apa yang dia nak cakap ialah velocity profile dia tak parabolic. Kalau parabolic, kita akan nampak dia punya color dia macam makin meningkat bila sampai ke center. Tapi ni dia macam tak berapa nak meningkat. Okay, so to explore more on this, you can plot in dataset, right click 2D cut plane yang tadi assignment tadi. Ni explore sendiri, okay. To cut line 2D. And then from there you can see the velocity profile. Bentuk parabolik ke tak parabolik. So yang ni pula yang Q tadi. Okay, nampak macam sama. Tapi velocity profile macam lain. Okay, kita assume yang salah ialah dalam nota dia salah. Okay, so that's all for today's lecture. Okay. So we have one more lecture next week. InsyaAllah Thursday, and that lecture is I want to show you how to do FSI simulation. Okay, FSI means fluid dengan solid mechanics. Kita combine sekali, macam mana kita nak tengok bila kita combine dua physics together. Okay, mungkin dia solve lama lagi daripada 15 minit tadi. Okay, so assignment 6 has already been uploaded. So due date dia minggu depan Ahad malam, okey. Okey, yang markah ni abaikan, bukan 10. Nanti saya post carry marks, okey. Okey, so you can start your project. Ada orang request nak brief project. So brief lah. Saya pun tak tahu nak brief apa project ni. Tak payahlah gemar.
Dalam dua ke saya? MU ni.
Itulah pasal baru nak buat lawak MU. Walaupun saya tak minat bola.
Rip cage macam mana ke?
Rip cage. Okay, rip cage tu korang design lah rip cage yang yang simple, maybe bentuk bentuk silinder ke. Bentuk silinder tapi ada macam mana nak lukis. Ni lukisan je. So maybe bentuk silinder. And then maybe korang cut sikit sini ke. Cut. Ni depends on creativity. Tak semestinya kena ribcage yang macam buruknya lukisan. Yang macam real human. Okay. Guna geometri yang ideal. Ideal geometri. Bentuk yang simple. Even dekat sini saya dah mention mana. Task 1 kot. Use ideal geometry ada tak? Tak adalah. Okay, so lukis geometry yang simple je. Macam ni, macam gigi ni, we can represent the gigi using cube. Okay. So tak perlulah lukis gigi. Lukis geometry yang simple bentuknya. For example, like rib cage ni, cylinder. Maybe prosthetic leg ni, maybe socket kan, kita nak socket. So socket maybe guna bentuk ellipse ke. Macam mana tengok je bentuk ni, kat mana? Okay, and then for transcranial, untuk kepala ni maybe guna ellipse untuk represent your head. Okay, and for muscle, functional muscle ni, maybe muscle bentuk silinder, okay. Muscle. Aortic dissection ni complicated sikit lah bentuk dia. Maybe bentuk payung ni. And then you add something here to represent dissection. Okay. Oh, head impact. So head impact ni maybe boleh guna bentuk sphere untuk represent your head. And then cerebral artery aneurysm. So aneurysm is bila your blood vessel jadi bentuk balloon. So maybe you can use a cylinder. And then somewhere in the middle you draw a bulatan, okay, to represent aneurysm. And then study the fluid flow.
Dalam 2D kan benda tu kan?
Yang fluid semua 2D. Yang fluid 2D. Fluid ni jangan try 3D lah sebab susah 3D. Lambat.
Kalau macam tu, kalau kamu buat just rectangle, lepas tu ada bulatan.
Boleh? Yes. Boleh.
Okay.
Even yang IoT dissection pun boleh buat bentuk rectangle. Tapi study lah dia punya aneurysm tu. IoT dissection tu. So ni task number one. Okay? Task number one basically reading. So task number two, you sketch in a paper or sketch dekat whiteboard dekat laptop ni. Macam mana korang nak translate from real geometry to ideal geometry. For example, gigi ni, maybe gigi bentuk macam ni. So this is real gigi. So you can translate this maybe in a cube shape. So this is ideal gigi. So explain sikit, we use a cube shape. Reason maybe simple to use. Macam tu. Ini janganlah ikut ayat yang sama, okay? And then maybe to study tooth filling, maybe you add something here in the middle. So this represent tooth filling. So yang task tu sketch ni, buat lebih kurang macam ni lah. Sketch je dekat kertas ke, tulis tangan ke. Macam mana nak korang punya idea tu? Macam mana korang nak translate from the problems, translate it into finite element. Nak buat geometri macam mana, and then maybe set the boundary condition ke. Maybe you can say the tooth material maybe yang modulus berapa, Poisson ratio berapa, So this one, the value may be from paper lah, from reference. And the tooth filling maybe use semen. Mungkin bahasa Melayu semen. So what is the value of Young modulus? Value of Poisson ratio. So ni pun dari paper. And then boundary condition maybe korang boleh state je lah. Apply force on top. So force on top represent kita mengunyah makanan. So explain sikit, force on top represent mengunyah makanan. Kunyah makanan. Tapi ni example yang teeth, okay. Example korang buatlah sendiri idea dia. Okay, maybe bila korang dah buat tu nak tunjuk kat saya pun boleh je. Okay, and then also think of one problem that you want to study. Okay, what problem that you want to study. So for example here, the problem to study is different filling material. Okay, so here the problem is what happen if we use different filling material when you apply the same force. Adakah gigi tu, adakah filling material tu cepat rosak ke? Ataupun sebagainya, okay. So for example, like let's say head impact during boxing. So maybe kepala, let's say you apply force on the left. So what happen if you use different force impact? Okay, maybe force yang lagi besar, ataupun what happen if you have more force? Okay, ada dua impact, kiri dan kanan. What happened to the head? So that's example for head impact. IOT dissection maybe ada berapa banyak tear, tear size ke. Siapa yang buat FYP IOT dissection tu, sedih lah tak dapat title ni. Okay, title number 2, muscle functional electrical stimulation. So FES, maybe you can study electrode size and also different layer in muscle or in our hand. So dalam FES ni maybe we assume only have muscle only, but we can also add bone ke or skin or fat layer ke. So what happen if you have this different layer, adakah electric signal tu boleh sampai ke muscle? Boleh study macam tu. And then rib cage ni maybe maybe force to apply secara menegak ke, secara sengit ke. Okay, so different force angle. Okay, maybe lah. Okay, fikirlah lagi nanti. Cerebral aneurysm ni maybe what happen if the aneurysm is the size of aneurysm, maybe balloon ni ada yang lagi besar ke? Mungkin bila lagi besar dia punya shear stress lagi tinggi. So blockage, so for blockage you can study the size of blockage, maybe size dia besar ni ataupun besar lagi. Okay, so what happened to the fluid flow at the blockage? Ada turbulent ke? Berapa banyak fluid yang boleh pass through? Okay, so benda-benda ni penting. Kalau fluid tu tak boleh pass through, maybe causing stroke, okay. And then stress on prosthetic leg, maybe you can use different prosthetic leg design. Size dia, okay. Kecil sikit ke ataupun bentuk persegi ke, for example. And for transcranial direct current stimulation, maybe you can use different electrode placement. Okay, so this is your head. Maybe kita letak electrode dekat lateral, kawasan tepi kepala, or dekat frontal, or dekat posterior ke. So what is the effect if you have more electrodes ke? Okay, you can study that as, you can take that as the problems. Okay, so that basically task 1 and task 2. And then task 3, basically you set up your idea in console. Okay, you can draw the geometry using SolidWorks, okay? And choose suitable physics. So physics dah bagi kat sini dah. Fluid, electrical, solid. And then apply boundary condition, use meshing, solve using static ke, dynamic ke, transient ke. And then task number 4, you analyze your result. So analyze ni open-ended. Tak kisahlah korang nak analyze apa, tapi analyze tu biarlah macam logik ataupun menarik sikit. Maybe you can verify your result with Wikipedia ke, paper ke, or any readings that you can find from Google. Okay, so lagi banyak creativity, lagi banyak markah for task 4. So from past seniors korang dulu, ada group yang present result yang by default je. Bila orang dapat result tu, dia terus present yang tu je. Dia tak plot result lain pun. So you can try plot other things yang you rasa menarik, okay? Menarik, boleh dapat findings yang yang menjawab persoalan problem study lah, okay? And then task 5 is your presentation. So usually presentation ni kita buat random. Random means maybe contohnya Zaim buat task 1, Mirza buat task 2. Saya suruh present, Mirza present task 1, Zaim task 2. So meaning that for presentation, I want you to study sama-sama, okay? Maksudnya kena tahu semua benda yang korang buat tu. Sebab saya panggil random je, okay? Awak present task 3, macam tu. So Q&A pula, individual marks. So kalau tolong kawan, markah tu tak dapat kat awak pun, okay? Kawan awak pun tak dapat markah. Oh, apa saya cakap ni? Apa-apalah, lebih kurang. Tapi kawan awak tak dapat markah. Okay, so any question? Any question that you care, that you want to ask? Maybe tak faham ke? So boleh start dah project, okay? Sebab dah week 9, ada 4-5 minggu lagi. If you have any question related to project, you can always ask me WhatsApp, through WhatsApp. Okay, so next week will be our last lecture. We will learn on FSI. And then after that, pulunlah untuk project dan test too. Okay, so if you have no more question, then that's it for today's class. Okay. Alamak, pergi rakam lah. Okay, so InsyaAllah see you guys next week. Assalamualaikum. Bye-bye.
Sir, sir. Saya kira apa?